Hi folks, today's recipe has been a long pending one to get into my channel. A well accepted bake, this has got many versions to it. Banana bread, as we all know, is a sought after bread which is easy and tasty to make. For a twist, I have made a crumble just to take it to another level. I'll be posting a healthy version of this in the near future. With handful of ingredients, you can bake a great cake without much effort. So guys, let's dig into this dish. As always, I'm starting off with the creaming of butter and sugar. But for this banana bread, I'm using brown sugar. I've taken half cup of room temperature butter here. Into this goes 1 cup of brown sugar, and we'll beat this up to a creamy thick texture. So there are some things which you have to take care when you bake a cake. For this banana bread, you don't have to take so much of effort or care as you do for a proper cake. So the butter and sugar is getting creamy and thick. I'll scrape down a bit and keep this aside and get ready with the rest of the stuff. Into a bowl, I'm taking 4 overripe bananas. Overripe bananas are the best for this banana bread because it will be sweet and more flavorsome. Crush this up with a fork. I'm not mashing or pureeing it. It should be mashed to a liquidy consistency, but you should have pieces of bananas in it. And this can be according to your preference. Those who don't like pieces of banana can mash it up completely, but better do it with a fork so you get the right consistency for it. The bananas are almost mashed now. I'll add the flavorings into this banana so that the flavor of banana and vanilla and cinnamon gets completely blended. I'm adding 1.5 tablespoon of cinnamon powder and 1 teaspoon of vanilla into the mashed up banana, and we'll blend all these things together to a loose consistency, which you can see here, but it is a bit liquidy, yet you can see the banana pieces. So the banana mixture is ready now. I am setting it aside and moving to the crumble part. For the crumble, you need 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, 2 tablespoons of almond meal or almond powder, 1/3 cup raw sugar, and 2 tablespoons of butter at room temperature. The butter should not be completely at room temperature, somewhere between room temperature and a bit cold, because this will make the crumble the right texture what we want. Combine all these ingredients together with your fingers so that you get a proper crumble. It will take some time and effort to do this with your hand, but it should be crumbly and moist like this. So the crumble is ready, the banana mixture is ready. Now we'll come back to the creamed butter and sugar. As you can see here, I'm whipping up the brown sugar and butter once more to make it more creamier, and in goes the eggs. I'm adding 2 eggs for this quantity. Now we'll combine the eggs with the butter and sugar mixture as we do for all the cakes. This should be whisked up till you get a very creamy texture. Keep the hand blender on medium speed, and once everything is combined well, you can increase to get a creamy texture. Scrape down the edges once in a while and then keep beating until the right consistency is attained. So the butter, egg and sugar mixture is ready here, as you can see. Next is the turn of dry ingredients. So I would like to make my cooking easier and less strainful, so we can add the dry ingredients directly by keeping the sieve on top of the bowl. And into this goes 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda or soda bicarbonate, and 1/3 teaspoon salt. We'll sieve this directly into the egg butter sugar mixture and mix it up with the hand blender only, but you should keep the speed on minimum or 1 and slowly combine. You should not beat it too much too. The egg butter mixture is almost combined with the dry ingredients. Now we'll add the banana mixture and give a quick mix. It should not be beaten for too long, just a minute of mixing will do, and you can see a creamy thick mixture here. Finally, I'm adding 2 tablespoons of yogurt into this, and we'll give a thorough mix with the spatula so that everything, the dry ingredients, the yogurt and the butter sugar mixture, everything get incorporated thoroughly. As you can see here, the batter is airy, fluffy and creamy. Now we can start the baking process. I'm preheating my oven at 180 degrees centigrade for 10 minutes. I've already set it on the temperature and started it. And I'm going to butter the loaf pan here. Just take some butter and you can do it with your hand as I'm doing it here. And transfer the banana bread batter into the loaf pan. Level it, and now it's the turn of the crumble. Add the crumble on top of the batter and level it as I'm doing it here. So the banana bread is ready to go into the oven. I'm baking it for 30 to 40 minutes. It will depend upon the oven you use. And then we get a soft, fluffy banana bread. As you can see here, texture is perfect. It's so light, airy, and giving a smell which is simply irresistible. So I'm going to taste this. So we all are going to enjoy this, and I want you all to try this out and do give me a feedback or put your comments in the box below. Hope you like my video. If you have, give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you soon with another episode. Take care and bye bye.